Hello learners, in today's lecture we will talk about subtopic 1.4 protection zones and backup protection. So let's pop through the video. After this session you will be able to define protection zones and backup protection, importance of backup protection and different methods of backup protection. Protection zone, what is it? Why protection zones? Such type of questions are in your mind. So let us start with the definition of protection zone. A protection zone is the area covered by a single protection system. I'm going to clear all things one by one. Just remember, try to remember the definition first. A protection zone is the area covered by a single protection system. Zones of protection. There is a separate protective scheme for each piece of equipment or element of the power system. As you all are familiar with the electrical power system, there are generators, transformers. So all these terms under the, they need protection. And that is why protection zones are defined for protection, generator protection, transformer protection, transmission line protection, bus bar protection, and etc. Students, stop this video and think why zones of protection are required. As I defined previously, a protection zone is the area covered by a single protection system. Means for right from generator, we need to give protection to each element of power system, for transformer, for transmission line, for distribution, and each and every element of protection system, power system needs protection. So protection zone is the area covered by a single protection system. It means if we are having thinking about generator, then the system or protection provided for that particular generator covers only generator. So that is a zone of protection provided for that generator. So why such type of zones of protections are required? Just try to understand. In this figure I have shown you, I am going to distinguish how, what is protection zone and why it is important. If any fault occurs on this particular transmission line in between point A and B, then what is expected? We are expecting that after occurring this fault, it should get cleared immediately. So to this A and B indicates two circuit breakers. So these circuit breakers are going to cover this particular transmission line, or you can say this A and B, these two circuit breakers are going to give protection to this particular transmission line from this point up to second point, from A to B. So after sensing the fault with this, with the help of these CTs, it will give command to trip circuit, to trip the circuit breaker and give the protection to entire power system. So this is a zone of protection for transmission line. After clearing this fault, this circuit breaker will again get closed and it will work normally. Now in second case, if fault will occur in this on this particular bus bar, now which circuit breaker will trip? So in this case, now circuit breaker A and B, both are not going to give any type of protection. So fault current will flow through the entire system and it subsequently it may fail the, it may interrupt the complete power system. So such type of things should not happen, and that is why zones of protections are important. Means particular region which covers the fault is getting defined with the help of that protection zone. In power system, for now see this figure. In this particular diagram, generator protection zone is shown here, by different color. Busbar protection zone is again shown by yellow color. Similarly, for transformer, we are giving some other protection. These two circuit breakers are going to protect this particular transformer section. Likewise, for each and every element or each and every component of power system is getting protected, and for each component or for each element of power system, we are having definite zone or definite region for the protection. One more thing you will find here, that in case of generator protection or in case of busbar protection, some regions are getting overlapped. So that is the overlapping of protection. Protection regions, protection zones. So why it is, that I am going to clear in the next slides. So from this diagram, you have to remember that for each and every component, for each and every element of power system, we are having definite protection zones, and all protection zones are overlap zones of protection. As you all are well familiar with electrical power system, which contains generator, transformer, busbar, transmission and distribution lines, we are having separate protection zone for each and every element. A protective zone covers one or at the most two elements of the power system. It means if you are having one generator and close to that generator you are having one transformer unit, then you can combinedly give protection to the generator and transformer unit. So you can have separate protection for transformer and separate protection to generator, or you can combine transformer and generator in a same zone, but the condition is maximum two elements you can cover in the single zone. No part of the protective system is left uncovered. This is a very important sentence. No part of the protective system is left uncovered. If some portion of busbar or some portion of transmission line is left unprotected, then if any fault occurs during that in that particular area, then it is going to disturb the complete power system, which may result into failure of entire system or complete shutdown of the power system. And that is why it is very, very important that no part of the protective system is left uncovered. One important definition or one important term related to that protection zone is a dead spot or blind spot. So the part of the system which is unprotected is known as dead spot or blind spot. As in the previous slide, I told you that no part of the power system should be left unprotected, and that part, if some part is left unprotected, that is called dead spot or blind spot. And to avoid the dead spot, use of overlapping is there in protection zones. So this is very important. Protection zones should be overlapped on each other to avoid dead spot or blind spots. Just stop the video again and think, which element decides the age of protection zones? Now you all are well familiar with the term protection zone. You also got one new term, that is blind spot or dead spot. So now, how to decide which is dead spot and which is a protection zone? The region which decides the protection zone. So how to decide it? Which element is going to decide the age of protection zone? The age of the protective zones is decided by the location of current transformer. Now see this figure. In this particular diagram, CT, this current transformer 1 and current transformer 2 is going to decide the protection zone provided to this particular transmission line. If Any fault occurs in between these two cities, then and then only that fault will be sensed by these two relay coils, and it will trip circuit breaker A and circuit breaker B. If any fault occurs out of the zone or on this particular bus bar, then it will not get sensed by these CTs, and so they will not trip the circuit breakers or they will not give protection to the power system, which may result into complete shutdown of power system. That is why protection system zones are very, very important, and that zone is getting decided by current transformers. Schemes of protection. So basically, protection schemes are divided into two parts. One is primary protection and other one is backup protection. Backup protection is again subdivided into three different parts. One is remote backup, other one is relay backup, and third one is breaker backup. So depending upon the location or type of backup provided in the electrical power system, protection schemes are named by remote backup, relay backup, or breaker backup. So let us discuss one by one. Primary protection. The primary system is divided into various zones for its protection. Primary relay is the first line of defense. So in electrical power system, as we are having generators, transformers, bus bars, transmission lines, everything, each element or each component is having its own protection zone, and different relays are assigned to sense the fault for that particular zone. If what will happen if that relay fails to operate, if that particular relay which is assigned to protect that particular zone fails to operate, in that situation it may hamper the complete power system, because the reliability of protective schemes is 95%. So primary protection is reliable about 95%. So what about remaining 5%? If that particular primary protection fails to operate, in that condition, to avoid the subsequent shutdown of entire power system, we are having backup protection. In our day-to-day life also, we are having primary plan, which, and if some activity is not able to execute, in that situation we are using backup protection or backup plan. In the same way, in a power system also, we are having second line of defense, second line of protection. If due to any reason primary relay fails to operate, then there is a backup protective scheme to clear the fault. It is a second line of defense. They are independent of primary relays to fail. It means it is somewhat different. Some different sensing elements are there to give you protection. When backup relay operates, a large part of the power system is disconnected. So primary protection zone is having its fixed region, some shorter region, and if that fails, then overlap zone is going to come into picture and it will protect the power system components. As there are different schemes for the backup. So first one is relay backup. So a single relay is used by both primary as well as backup protection, but protective systems are different. So it is a one type in which single element is used for primary as well as secondary protection, but the protective systems are different. Breaker backup protection. In this scheme, separate breaker is provided for primary and backup protection. So if this particular bus bar is protected with circuit breaker C, D, and E, then if any of these circuit breaker fails to operate, in that case, circuit breaker A or circuit breaker B will give protection to this particular bus bar. This is how bus bar will get protected by breaker backup protection. Third is remote backup. Separate breakers are provided for primary and backup protection. So in case of remote protection, separate primary and backup protections are there. Two types of breakers are at different locations and are completely isolated and independent of each other. So if one element fails, then second element will come into picture. That is remote backup protection. In addition to these three types, one more type is there, and that is centrally coordinated backup protection. In this method, primary protection is at various stations. So it is having central control room and backup protection control for all stations from central control room. There are some reference books from which you can cover these protection zones. Thank you.